First off, I call myself an accidental filmmaker.
You are an accidental filmmaker. What do you mean by that?
So many people, they dream of making movies, and that was never my vision. I had never given it any thought. I thought I was going to go into the ministry.
And a lot of my friends went forward, and they were, you know, I felt God calling me to be a preacher or a youth minister or a missionary. And I felt God calling me. And I was like, oh, you know, God, this is great. I'm so excited. So what do you want me to do? And God very plainly said, I can't tell you, because what I'm calling you to do, you don't even know exist. And I'm like, what are you talking about? Okay, obviously I've misunderstood God. And so, you know, I didn't tell anybody. I didn't go forward because I was like, what am I going to say? God's called me, but I don't know what he's called me to do.
And he began praying for Lottie Moon and for that missionary that they needed. 3 years later, he was preaching a sermon, and he happened to mention in passing about Lottie Moon and about how she had mentioned the need for a doctor to be a missionary. In his congregation was a Presbyterian doctor who heard that sermon, and it got his mind rolling. And 10 years from the time that she first spoke to those women and said, we need a doctor, that Presbyterian doctor, who was now Baptist and married, came over to China, and he not only became the missionary that was needed, but he actually became her personal doctor.
As Christians, a lot of times it's very hard to speak so that the world can understand.
And so, you know, I ask our actors, I'm like, okay, which theaters do you think we should screen at? There was not a single AMC in Tennessee at the time.
Right.
But we had one of the actors who lived in New York City, and he was like the first to respond, and he said, okay, you need to be at the AMC Empire. He said, that's the one at Times Square. I'm like, yeah,
oh, wow.
Right. Yeah. Okay, no, seriously.
Sure, no problem. Let me call them up, you know.
Exactly. So I'm like, yeah. People, seriously, where should we go? He's like, it doesn't hurt to ask.
Yeah.
And so I'm like, okay, so I put it on our list of ones for them to contact. They were the first one that got back with us and said yes.
Nice.
And so we're like, okay, that's really wild. Well, then we discovered the story years ago. He and his wife had moved to Manhattan, and they went to the theater, and the theater is so big they have an escalator inside the theater.
Right.
He was coming down the escalator, and he prayed. He said, God, someday let me be coming down this escalator after having seen a movie that I was in. And at the time, he had never been in a movie. He was a stage actor, and he traveled around doing a one-man show all around the world. But from that point on, he started doing movies. And he has been in Alone Yet Not Alone and Beyond the Mask, you know, pretty big movies.
Sure.
But he had smaller parts in it.
Right.
Ours was his first leading man role, and we're the one that got in.
Well, Sharon, I want to thank you for making a difference with your life.